For over a decade, the Eastern Democratic Republic of Congo has been heavily infested with rebel and terrorism activities that have been terrorizing civilians along the western border of Uganda. The Allied Democratic Forces, ADF, has been one of the notorious rebel groups abducting and carrying out war crimes against innocent civilians, including the children. This compelled the UPDF and the Congolese army to join forces through Operation Shuja to rid the region of rebel activities. These are some of the former ADF abductees that were rescued by the UPDF. They shared shocking details of their time in captivity. Shockingly, children as young as 5 years were lured into terrorism by their own parents. For the boys, military training and Islamic indoctrination were a must, as they recount. Though young in age, many of these children have seen worse than their ages could contain. These children say they could watch their colleagues die at the hands of their merciless captors. According to the UPDF spokesperson, in the last operation held in Intoroko district, over 23 ADF combatants were captured, and these have been undergoing rehabilitation by the UPDF and other agencies. Kulaije condemned the acts of recruiting children into rebel activities, as this deprives them of their rights.
We have 48, both Ugandans and the Congolese, that were formerly ADF elements, of whom 23 were captured during the attempt to infiltrate the country in Ntoroko, December 2022. That we condemn the abuse of children. The use of children in combat operations is total abuse of their innocence, total abuse of their childhood, and therefore a damaged childhood.
Meanwhile, those in captivity have been encouraged to surrender themselves to authorities to benefit from amnesty provided by the Ugandan government.
And teach them dispute resolution, alternative dispute resolution mechanisms, but also educate them on the Ugandan government, its agencies and parastatals that they can report to if anyone trampled over their rights, so they don't need to use violence. They can report to the police, to the intelligence agencies or elsewhere in order to get their grievances addressed.
And I want to remind you that we give amnesty once. If you re-offend what we call recidivism, then we don't give you forgiveness again. And so we urge you, please, behave so well, we will be able to follow you and see how we can help you settle back in your communities.
Those rescued include 5 adult male Ugandans, 5 girls, 12 boys, and 4 juveniles, while the Congolese include 2 male adults, 2 women, 8 girls, and 10 boys. They will be awarded certificates as proof of their amnesty. Rachel Nachwala reporting for the news.